So, as Dr. Olson said, it was a rapid improvement event for radiology associates. And what they do is they're an imaging diagnostic center, so they do x-rays, CAT scans, things like that. But we're targeting their marketing campaign. So briefly, what an RIE is, it's an intensive week-long, really it's just a meeting day by day for 5 days where you highlight a problem and you try to just go all in and work through it in the process I'll show you in a second. So I did a couple things. I did a VSM for the process of that week-long event, and then later on I'll show you some of the tools we use and an informational A3, which I thought kind of captured the best practices in the RA. Okay, so the first step is the VSM. And so if you look up in the right-hand corner, there's doctors and investors, and basically all they want to do is get a 10% increase in revenue. So they communicated the sales information, the current sales information, and their budget, which was, I don't know if I should say, $81,000 for advertising, and, to the marketing director, really. And from there, the marketing director contacted our RIE sensei, who was actually, he's a black belt in lean, and he works for Simpler, which is a company in the Bay Area. And so the marketing director and the sensei, they talked about the goals and the targets and expected results. And so the RA sensei came down from the Bay Area for 5 days, brought his industry experience, and worked with the marketing director for the prep period, which is actually very extensive, 2 to 3 months. And I'll talk more about that in a little bit later. So the first day, we did training and review. So all the attendees were basically department leads. There's an outside sponsor that works with radiology associates. And we just kind of informed them of the CSM, the current state map, and the completed A3, which was done in that prep period. It was 2 to 3 months. And so that was a 7-hour day, 1-hour lunch. There's a Kaizen burst here because I thought that the training, it was apparent that the training that we did in the prep phase was not significant, not beneficial enough. And so what I thought they could do there is maybe do an FAQ or some sort of handbook that just kind of gives a terminology, because there was a lot of questions that took a lot of time during that RIE process. So day two, we focused on the market, and we looked at our current revenues, current sales, the competition, and 2 partnering hospitals. Another Kaizen burst here, I thought that the market analysis, we were making phone calls like to competitors trying to get their sales information, their pricing, things like that during the event, which I think that could have been done beforehand because, like I said, the sensei is really expensive. We come down from the Bay Area and we really want to focus on objectives and how to get there rather than the grunt work. Okay, so day three, and so from there, that information box or triangle, we did like a SWOT analysis, a PEST analysis, which is political, economic, social, and technological, things like that, which I'll go into later. Day three, we looked at planning. So we looked at the customer profile, both the person that uses the imaging and also the referring doctors, because we thought of them as a customer as well. And we just kind of brainstormed all the possibilities. Day four, we created action plans. So we analyzed the tools that we used and we started making decisions. Day five was just a report out, and we compiled all of our decisions and summarized the process and divvied up who was going to present to the doctors and the investors. And I should also say too that we did a report out at the end of every single day, as you can see in the mid right hand corner there. And so we kind of summarized what we did and what we needed from the doctors and the investors, because all this information, we can't just act on it. We formulate a hypothesis of what we think it'll work or will work and try to get them to get some buy-in in that process. In the middle of the screen there, I just kind of went to the director of marketing and I said, all right, well, regarding the different days, how will they need to follow up and what will they need to do to create actionable items. And so for day one of the training review, they need to really follow up with that, because the RAE that RA does, radiology associates, they do multiple RAEs, not just for marketing. They've done 8 of them before. And so I think that looking at their training process, they could really reevaluate and improve that. As far as market analysis, we created a Google Drive document, and so all of these files are in there. So what she's going to need to do is keep on, as information comes up, update the market analysis. Day three, they need to adjust the planning as necessary. Day four, implement and redesign the action plans as planning requires. And finally, ongoing meeting with owners for the report out. So here I just wanted to show you the process a little bit in pictures. You can see that we worked in a room, pretty big room, big table, about nine people. And we started out in the upper left-hand corner, you can see with just bare walls. It was just an A3 on the wall. And some of the training items, like the seven weights, things like that. And then in the right-hand corner, upper right, you can see that at the end of it, it was just filled with tools, essentially. And in the middle, the agenda. Also, like the first group that presented today, I like this circle with the kind of cutouts to show progress made. I think it's a good way to look at where you're at. So this is a different application of it. So I thought that was interesting. Then in the bottom left and the bottom right, there's that pest and the reverse fishbone that we talked about earlier. Okay, so next, this is an informational A3. It's different than the ones we've been working on in class. So the background, Radiology Associates did not have a strategic marketing plan to achieve their 2014 goals. So what we need to do is gather all the data and look at how we can best allocate our budget to increase our revenues. The attendees you can see there, the sensei facilitator, they termed me outside eyes, and then we had an industry professional. And then on that note too, the industry professional, back to this slide, the better prep, I think that something they need to do is, whoever's going to attend this event needs to be really the type of person that's outgoing, outspoken, and really knows what they're talking about. This industry professional was not. He didn't talk at all, and so it was basically a waste of his time and our resources to pay him to be there. Moving on.
What kind of professional? Was he a doctor professional or a lead?
Yeah, so he worked with a referring doctor, essentially. So he could provide information on what the process is like and how to streamline it a little bit. Because that's where they get a lot of their leads and their revenue through referring doctors.
Right.
Activities realized, again, it's a 5-day since I led a meeting. With the goal of determining the best way to gain revenue. And then I showed a couple of the tools that we use there, and I blew them up in a different slide, so I'll wait on that. Expectations compared to actual, overall I thought it did a good job. It would be worth considering doing more RAs for different processes like they do already. Key points and lesson learned. So, as I said, the prep stage is really important. And consists of 2 to 3 months. The first step, which is about 3 months out, is the RA selected, what we're going to aim to achieve. Select the sponsor, which is the sensei from Simpler. Next step, about a month out, is to gather the team and start creating an A3. The third step is to hone in the event scope, produce some deliverables, the return on investment, which is working with the investors and the doctors, and then create a current state value map. Finally, you want to collect the required data and complete team training. So the required data would be something like how many, I have it later on, I'll show you, but it wasn't really relevant with the data that they brought to the table, so I think they need to do that. And finally, in that lesson learned box, I think that they have an opportunity to improve other processes. Which arose in the process, so in the RA process. So there you can't really see it, but that's a standardized work list, and that's a good way to train their crew, or their staff rather, on exactly what they need to do when, which is not happening right now. It's kind of all over the board as far as training goes. The weak points of the RA, lack of input, which I mentioned, communication hindrances, so we wanted to say we wanted to approve a step that we thought was beneficial to the marketing process. We had to call a doctor, and sometimes we couldn't get a hold of them, so that kind of made us wait during the RA, which was inefficient. And then we wasted too much time, like I mentioned too, on the training. Improvements identified. I think that we need to invite attendees after they've been tested or vetted in a way. Training could occur prior to the RIE, so the sensei was doing a lot of training. They did some before, but again, the FAQ or just a template of terminology would reduce the amount of interruptions. And then finally, one decision maker should attend, one of the doctors or the investors should attend at least one day of the event. Okay, so now I want to go into, we said that we wanted a 10% revenue, so these are some of the goals more in depth. We broke down all the different types of imaging scans they did, like a PET scan, a CT scan, mammo, and we said, okay, well, if we want 10%, then how are we going to break that down? What's realistic to achieve? Another tool that we use is the influence versus impact, and I think this is really effective and something that you might want to make a note of in your career. Basically, you just want to target the upper right-hand corner, the high impact, group the impact, and how much influence do you have? So we said that the high rollers, these referring doctors, they have the most amount of impact and influence. So that's what we want to direct a lot of our marketing budget towards versus, I don't know what some of these mean actually, I forget, but yeah. Another tool, this is the planning stage worksheet.
It looked like women's health at Poly was pretty low.
Yeah, okay, so the Poly thing, we created names. We did the customer profile. We created names, like nicknames, for all of our customer profiles. One of them was Women's Health. Yeah, so that's just what the Poly is. But, yeah. Which is a good way to do it, too, just to identify who your target customer is. So this is a prep phase. Again, the items in yellow are the critical to achieve, and so again, you have the time, 3 months prior, and so on. So another way of organizing information by color coding, simple visual. And then finally, to highlight our deliverables, we came up with a completion plan. You can see Jessica is the guru in a lot of these, and she's the director of marketing. She's working with a big team, so I think that maybe we should look at, you know, a supporting person to help her with some of this because it's a lot. And we have status when it gets completed. This gets uploaded to Drive so we can see it and edit it. And that is my presentation.
Questions?
I was curious, slide number 7. I've seen that before where they have a number of actions looking at different timelines.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a particular name to this kind of, just a value stream team, what's the name of this kind of approach, you know?
I don't think it, unless I'm wrong, I don't think it is anything like value stream team. That's just who is in charge. So the top acronyms there, those are the people in charge,
yeah.
Right? But as far as the name of this document, I think it's just a prep worksheet. Yeah.
On your last slide?
Yeah.
Would a Gantt chart been appropriate there? Or feasible?
I guess. I don't know. This works. It's visible and clear. But yeah, you could definitely experiment with other options. It's easier. The thing about that is a lot of these people that are working with this, they don't know really how to use a Gantt chart. What it, you know. Not to say they can be trained, but it's just one more thing to train.
I think I walked in right when we were starting. Mm-hmm. Your role, since they have a sensei they hired, your mm-hmm. role was to look at the event and see how the event was effective?
Yeah,
but
so
not to take them through the lean process.
Definitely not. Yeah, I was learning the whole time from this sensei guy. I was there just for outside eyes, basically. And I would, you know, obviously comment on what I thought could benefit them in a way. And then a lot of what I've been doing is actually after this RIE event, I brought them in as a SBDC client, and so we've been connecting them with different resources. Because one of the things that we decided they needed to do was a search engine optimization. So just giving them the right resources and identifying what those resources are and what they need, that was my goal.
So it looks like going into this rapid improvement event, there was a lot of pre-processed information, right? So you were sort of looking at this sort of pile of information, and the event was about using different tools to sort of organize it and understand what the current state was, so you could do that sort of 10%.
Correct.
In additional revenue.
Yeah, exactly.
And did it look like it worked?
Yeah, it definitely worked. I mean, you don't know that until you see the revenue generation, but as far as creating the processes and creating the steps to get to that stage to invest that money, we definitely did that. So it'll be interesting to see how that turns out with them. But they weren't doing like any radio advertising, very minimal. They weren't doing hardly anything as far as marketing goes. Yeah. And so just seeing where they could best allocate their funds is interesting, yeah.
Did they, it seems like they have an in-house marketing person.
They have one lady.
Okay, because have they ever thought about just going to a company that does marketing? There's a local company at the Interactive that does marketing for doctors.
Right.
And they do everything. They'll do your Facebook, they'll do your whole plan. So you just, instead of trying to have somebody in-house do all of that and train the person and put a load on them, they could hire an external partner and say, this is our goal, you help us get there.
Yeah. I think that's a valid, point. I think that looking at it from the doctor's perspective, they like somebody that knows their business from the inside and kind of can bring that to the table. Not to say that maybe she could be like the liaison, whatever you say, between that marketing and the company.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think, and she's being paid salary, so maybe if you cut that position out or whatever, then you could look at that outsourcing of the marketing campaign, say, okay, that might be effective, but I think funds were an issue for that too. Yeah. Not sure, not to say this.
Well, you said they were going to pitch $80,000
towards
marketing.
Yeah, but that, if you think about it, like hiring somebody to do all that, that could probably take a significant chunk out of that $80,000.
Yeah, but then they do it for you.
They do it for you.
Yeah, that's
a lot. Yeah, no, totally.
Yeah.
I have a question about your impact and influence chart. Like what is the difference really? Is the influence mean influence to like the industry?
Influence is how much can we actually influence their decision. So versus impact is how much are they gonna, if we do influence them, how much more revenue can we bring from that person? If that makes sense.
Yeah. Okay. So it's kind of convincing the money holders. The influence part is how sellable is this idea, and the impact is how much impact will it have.
Yeah, kind of. It's not so much how sellable is the idea, it's how much, upper right hand corner example, those are the doctor referrals. They bring the revenue in, or they refer clients to, do the CAT scan and whatnot.
Okay.
We can influence them a lot by doing, we created different ways to, help refer them to us, and they can also bring in a lot of revenue if we do that. Yeah.
Process slide?
Where was that?
Can you do first or second? That agenda? Is that your agenda for the day or
the That's for the whole
process?
Entire week.
The whole project.
Right. Yeah, so we got, that was just day one, the photo that we did day one. And we changed that a little bit, but for the most part, that was something that we produced in the prep stages too. So we followed that pretty much to the
In the prep stage, so this was before the event?
Before the event, yeah. We thought of what we wanted to achieve and how we were going to achieve that, what tools, so a lot of those are that you can see the SWOT and test and things like that.
So the people in this room are not doctors, they're staff people.
Exactly, yeah. Staff people that are working the front desk, different leads at different departments. There was one doctor there, as you can see in the upper left-hand corner, she was a doctor, but she was only there briefly, and
it's tough to get those guys to...
Yeah, they're busy.
And they own the business, and they... make all the decisions, right?
Right.
So that's sort of part of the thing. Not having them in a room is generally a problem.
Right.
Kinds of decisions. Could you talk a little bit more about the, Andy Soft talks more. Can you talk a little bit more about the communication hindrances? So what was that?
Okay, so I think that was twofold. So the first was getting a hold of those doctors when we said, okay, well, for example, it's a really confusing thing to try to communicate this whole process in 20 minutes because there's, as far as going back to the pest, the political part of it, they're in at some hospitals, but they're also, it's kind of shaky as where you can direct your marketing efforts. And so we had a question as far as, all right, can we target this area for marketing in the hospitals specifically? And so we wanted to confirm that with the doctor before we pursued that option further. And so not being able to get a hold of that person right away was, it delayed us, it kind of just.
Right,
because
they weren't in the room.
Yeah. Right, and then also, between the individuals in the room, the terminology again, that was something that was confusing. And again, not having the right people that were those outspoken people and that were really there because they wanted to be there to improve this process.
So there's some people that were sort of being dragged to this?
You could tell they were not enthusiastic about being there and therefore they didn't contribute as much as they did.
All right.